Online gambling market continues to achieve the double-digit growth. Online gambling market achieved a double-digit growth size and surpassed $55 billion in 2019 and is anticipated to grow at a 16.5% CAGR between 2020 and 2026. With the advent of several new technologies such as AI, VR, cyborg and machine learning will drive the growth of online gambling. As more and more people are now willing to gamble online, the global online gambling market is now one of the biggest and it is expected to grow up to $127.3 billion by 2027 with a CAGR of 11.5%. The world is still dealing with the pandemic and people are now trying to stay safe in their homes. Many land casinos and bookies remain closed, but gambling activities continue. This year, it is likely that people will continue to gamble online instead of traveling. Mobile has become the key influencer to online gambling as online gambling has become more accessible because of mobile technology. Because of mobile devices, people can now play their favorite casino games wherever they are in the world. Gambling companies are also shifting their focus towards the mobile markets and many more games and gambling apps are expected to release this year. While the present 4G connection is already good enough for gaming and browsing, it just keeps getting better as the 5G networking is expected to start in 2021. With an extremely fast internet connection, the gaming experience is going to get much faster and better. Let's look into today's headlines in Proud India. Proud India celebrating its 72nd Republic Day today. India is celebrating its 72nd Republic Day this year. It is a day when every community comes together and celebrates leaving past all their differences. However, it is the first to be organized amid the COVID-19 pandemic, which means celebrations are taking place with many changes, including a shorter route for the parade and much less public participation in the event. There will be no chief guest at the event for the first time in decades after British Prime Minister Boris Johnson called off his India trip due to the COVID-19. The number of marching contingents from the armed forces will remain the same, but the numbers making up each contingent have been reduced from 144 to 96. Each member of the contingent will be wearing a mask as per the protocol laid down by the Indian government to prevent the transmission of COVID-19. Voter ID cards have gone digital. The Election Commission of India formally launched the EEPIC, that is Electronic Electoral Photo Identity Card program, on January 25th, the National Voters Day. EEPIC is a non-editable, secure, portable document format, that is PDF version of the EPIC, and will have a secure QR code with image and demographics like serial number, part number, etc. EEPIC can be downloaded on a mobile or a computer and can be digitally stored. This is in addition to the physical IDs being issued for fresh registrations. Information security biggest challenge to national security, says Army Chief. Army Chief General M.M. Naravane said information security is the biggest challenge to national security in the present scenario, which can give a strong shock to the economy and can handicap government machinery also. In his virtual address on the topic of India's national security scenario, past, present and future, General Naravane said national security was not limited to armed security only, but is based on six other important foundations. General Naravane said information security is the biggest challenge to national security in the present scenario. Qualcomm faces cybersecurity issue impacting visitor check-in system. Qualcomm has suffered a cybersecurity issue impacting the security of its visitor check-in system. The tech giant has begun notifying impacted individuals of the issue in a privacy notice, which reads, "Last week on January 15th, we became aware of an issue affecting the security of Qualcomm's visitor check-in system. The attack left impacted users' information exposed to unauthorized access. Information such as an individual's contact and employer information, citizenship and the date, time and purpose of their visit has been exposed. Facebook suddenly locked out of iPhones globally. iPhone users using the Facebook iOS app faced a situation where they had to log in to the app again. That's because the social media giant locked out almost every iPhone user around the world on Friday night. Soon after iPhone users unknowingly got locked out of the app, several started talking about it on Twitter. While most of them had to log back in, some with two-factor authentication faced failed sessions and delays in the login process as the SMS codes arrived late. Facebook is aware of the issue. The company spokesperson said that this might have happened due to a configuration change and the firm is looking into it. Arnab Goswami paid $12,000 and rupees 40 lakhs to fix ratings, said Partho Dasgupta. The former CEO of Broadcast Audience Research Council, that is BARC India, Partho Dasgupta, has submitted a handwritten statement to Mumbai police that he received $12,000 from Republic TV editor-in-chief Arnab Goswami for two separate holidays and a total of rupees 40 lakhs over 3 years in return for manipulating ratings in favor of the news channel, according to the supplementary charge sheet filed in the TRP scam case. The 3,600-page supplementary charge sheet also includes a BARC forensic audit report, WhatsApp chats purportedly between Dasgupta and Goswami, and statements of 59 persons, including former council employees and cable operators. BSNL-MTNL merger shelved as group of ministers says not feasible, cabinet to meet soon. The plan to revive the state-owned telecom companies Bharat Sanchar Nigam, that is BSNL, and Mahanagar Telephone Nigam, that is MTNL, by merging the two entities is set to be shelved after almost 2 decades of deliberations on the matter. A 6-member group of ministers, that is GOM, mandated to take a call on the issue, is learned to have recommended last week that a merger would neither be beneficial nor feasible, thereby closing a long-drawn chapter in the telecom sector. The Union Cabinet will meet soon to formally decide against such a merger. Xiaomi rolls out Mi Notebook 14 IC with 10th Gen Intel Core i5 processor. Xiaomi has launched in India the 10th Gen Intel Core i5-10210U Comet Lake processor powered Mi Notebook 14 IC laptop. Priced at ₹43,999 onwards, the thin and light laptop comes in multiple configurations, including a variant with NVIDIA GeForce MX250, 2GB GDDR5V RAM, discrete graphic card. The Mi Notebook 14 IC will be available in silver color on Mi online stores, Mi Homes, Amazon India, Flipkart and select retail stores. Amazon allies with Startup India to enhance e-commerce exports from India. Amazon launched Amazon Global Selling Profile, that is AGSP, an initiative that aims to provide support to emerging Indian brands and startups to reach customers around the world. Thus, Amazon has partnered with Startup India to launch an accelerator program to help early-stage startups in the consumer product space. It will help them launch in international markets and create global brands from India through AGSP. Milestone Systems appoints Sandesh Kaup as new country manager for India. Milestone Systems has announced the appointment of Sandesh Kaup as the new country manager for India and SAARC. Sandesh Kaup rejoins the Milestone family after 4 years. Previously, he handled a senior leadership position at Allied Telesis, a telecommunications company. In his earlier tenure at Milestone, Sandesh had nurtured the sales growth in India. He oversaw a 40% year-on-year growth from 2011 to 2015. Apart from building important business accounts, he also played an instrumental role in building synergies. He has also created an ecosystem, that is solution partner, across server storage, networking, access control manufacturers, command control software and other third-party software. Summing up, growing concerns related to cybercrime will hamper the market growth. Manipulation of internet sites through fake apps and app-based hacking leads to high risks for individuals providing credit card information. A report says a group of professional Chinese hackers targeted and hacked companies that run online gambling and online betting websites in Southeast Asia. Furthermore, the dramatic increase in the usage of online gambling by minors due to easy accessibility to the internet is restricting the market growth. The players are shifting to online gambling and signing up to their favorite online casino sites during COVID-19, as many are not advised to visit the physical gambling or casino zones. The work from home milieu has prompted more companies to give a push to their gender diversity agenda. The data shows a 22% increase in work from home job opportunities exclusively for women professionals in 2020. It further influences the growth of the IT/ITES sector and has been one of the prime advocates of digital adoption. Traditional legacy-based security setups and tools like VPNs are increasingly becoming more and more inadequate in securing cloud applications, hence increasing new security risks and challenges for the gamers too. Wishing you all a very happy Republic Day. With this, let's wind up for the day. But do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. You can download the War India app from Google Play Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned and have a nice day.